Ben, what are we doing?
You know how I made that little Cessna?
Yeah.
I wanted to make a bigger one.
How much bigger?
240%.
That's a lot bigger, Ben.
Yeah, that's a lot bigger. And it can carry this battery, which is the one I flew the C-17 on back in the day. But we're gonna maiden it on, you know, instead of a 6,000, we'll go with a 5,000. I mean, you know, we don't wanna go crazy or anything.
So what motor's in this?
This, thank you Flite Test for trusting me. This is the new FT Monster Radial. And I've tucked it away in there so you can't really see it, but it's really, really, really cool. And I've got this nice old, I think it's like a 13.6 old gasser prop that one of the old timers handed me down to. This is way underpropped for that motor. That motor will turn a 20-inch, maybe even a 22 on 4-cell, according to Bixler. So this is a 13, and low pitch, as far as I know, 13.6, that's nothing. But it sounds really cool. And the whole airplane probably weighs 5 pounds. It's a 6-foot span. The wings over there, we'll get that here in a second.
So but why the Cessna?
When I was a little kid, my grandfather was a flight instructor, and so in his off time, he would take me to the airport and teach me to fly. There's pictures of me with him. I was probably like 6 years old. You know, and he would put a phone book under me and taped 2x4s to the pedals so that I could at least feel what he was doing. He owned a old Cessna 150M. And so over last Thanksgiving, I just got a wild hair in my head. I thought, you know, I want to make a plane for my grandpa. So that's actually where the little Cessna came from. And then as I saw Flite Test messing around with that Monster Radio, I said, oh, I need to make a bigger Cessna, obviously. So this is my 150 for my grandpa, Big Al. He taught my dad to fly. My dad actually was his first private pilot student, and I was his last private pilot student. And then he continued on for like 30 years after he retired. He flunked retirement, got bored, and became a flight instructor. But so after me, he pretty much only taught the instructors. So he was the CFII, the instructor who taught the instructors into his 80s. And he was just a great guy. So many good memories flying with him. And yeah, so this is for Grandpa Al. All right, we're all plugged in. You have to excuse the super awesome gassers in the background. I'll try and talk over them, but if not, just watch what I'm doing, right? So we got battery tray secured here. We got our XADR plugged in with all the bits and bobs. We got flaps, and because the wing is so much thicker when you scale it up, I was able to hide the servos inside. So we just got push rods coming out to some good old Dan Sponholz 3D printed FT push rod control horns there. And we're gonna close them up. And so we got two things holding the wing on. We got the wing saddle pins, which are good old barbecue skewers, reinforced with some 3D printed washers. And then I'll show you how the wing struts. On the little Cessna, the wing struts are mostly just for looks, and they're made out of barbecue skewers. But on this one, the wing struts actually are functional, just like on the real Cessna. So, slide these guys in past each other. Okay. And I've also got a little guide inside to help me find the hole on the other side. Because this body is the fuselage is so wide, there's no way I'd be able to just blindly find that hole every time. So I've got a little guide in there to help the skewer find its way across.
You haven't got a starter yet, huh?
I have a starter. I just don't have the battery.
Turn this guy off.
This one I modified myself.
And then, this is the fun part. So, bring this guy in here. There's a little brass tube at the end of this guy. And he's gonna slide on right there. And so this is a bent steel push rod that's a heavier gauge, so it's not gonna just unbend itself. So now that guy is working great in tension. And I'm gonna just do the other end on the other side here.
we've got a steerable nose wheel all in there. And Alex was kind enough to have his shop, his guys bring me some landing gear. And I think we are ready to go. That's right. Okay, that's good. Yeah, it turns right. And then, let's see, flaps. Our flaps coming down. Okay, we're there. And we got inline. We got all the rates dialed in. Cool. All right. Then let's check our prop. Can't wait. We're gonna wait though until these guys are done. Because they scare me. Good. Quarter cord. Nose heavy.
Nose heavy's always better.
Well, here goes something. Like a Cessna.
I was gonna say, is this gonna be one of those uneventful maidens?
Yes, please.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Hands off. Hey, there's another one over there.
Yeah, there is.
So we're about half throttle right now, so we're cruising at about 15 amps.
All right, I'm gonna pick it up and drop the flap.
One notch flap, nose comes up. Slowed down pretty nice. Sorry we're so far away, but all right, let's clean up. And then we're back clean. Cruising level.
You know what? The other thing I forgot to talk about that I was worried about was the struts. Because they're so thin, just structurally, they're pretty flimsy. They've got a carbon rod on the leading edge, but I was honestly worried that there would be some flutter and that they would just maybe rip themselves off the airplane. But obviously they're still attached, and we're still flying, so I'm happy with that. Even lying, I seriously am having flashbacks to my flight training. I can see myself on approach at John Wayne with my grandpa, and I can hear him in my ear, "Stop flying the plane, Ben. Stop flying the plane. Let it land. Let it land."
You can't even barely hear the thing, but when you hear it, it sounds not electric. I love it.
Alright, we'll do the next one with full flaps. Okay. That was a close ago.
I think I gotta take that one.
See what's the damage on the battery. Like 60%. It's cold. It's literally cold. 64%.
No way.
64% left. Oh, that's
awesome.
Yeah, it's only down to 15.6. And then speed controller's down in there. It's cold. Motor's cold. I mean, like I said, it's under prop, so it's not surprising, you know, that it lasted so long, and yeah, it's good.
All right, Ben, so did it fly like a Cessna?
Dude, it just started flying like a Cessna. I mean, I can't even, it sounds so silly.
So basically, you can get bored flying this airplane.
You know, you'd think so, but I had to land because I knew the other guys wanted to get up. This Spitfire is awesome, and I do not want to be in the air with him. But no, I didn't get bored. I could do touch and goes for a half an hour, and the battery would let you. It's just so much fun. Yeah, it flies so much like a Cessna. You slow it down, put the flaps, and just sort of, it's awesome. It's really fun. I'm very, very pleased.
Successful fly day.
I will, in some form or another, we'll get plans out. I don't know. I can't tell you when, but we'll have the little one out. We'll get this one out, at least in plans form on the forum at some point. So stay tuned for that. Thanks again to Flite Test for letting me play around with that monster radial. It is, this is the low end of what I can do. But it's awesome. I love the new radio motors. They're really, really good. Anyway, thanks for hanging out. Thanks for watching me fly. See you next time. Woohoo! Thanks, Grampa.